Okay, in last hands-on, we first use the handles, the global variable which we used to send the data over the transmit function. The handles are usually used to notify our API, the HL API, what are the parameters and what the function need to do, which is the periphery. Then definitely for the transmitting we need to give this handle. Then don't forget always use these handles and define them usually as a global, or you can use the different approach. Okay, what is in the handler? Definitely there is the instance which periphery to use. There is some initialization parameters, in our case which baud rate. There is also what is the state of the periphery, if it's busy, if end up with the error, or if it's ready. And also some links between if this periphery is linked with the DMA or with the other periphery. And also some internal status like the what is the buffer address, how many bytes we want to send, or how many bytes was already sent. These are internal parameters which we need the handler need to know. Then this is reason why the handler must be always present during the transmitting. One time. Yes, when we sending the data with the handle, in our case over UART, we have the physical UART on our chip, we have the handle in our software, and when we want to send initialize first the periphery, we call the init function. This function store all this information into the handle, and then the handle during the initialization is used to store the correct parameters into UART periphery registers. Then with the transmitting, when we want to send the data, we first store this information into handle to how many bytes we want to send, where find the bytes. And then during the sending, this information I read from the handle and set inside the UART periphery. Okay, the pull up. We now know how this works, how works looks like a little bit the handle structure in the graphical way. Okay, what is inside? Now we can look what is directly inside the structure. We can see that there is the instance, we know this, the init parameters, but there is also the lock. If this function is now modifying the registers, that to be sure that no other function can call the work with the UART within the same time. There is the state if the periphery is busy, if end up in the timeout or with the error, and also we can discover the error code because the different peripherals can have different errors. On the UART can be, for example, priority error or the overrun error. Then we have definitely pointer to the transmit buffer, how many data we want, how many bytes we want to send, and how many bytes was already sent over UART. This variable is used during the transmission, and the same is for the reception. And also, when we start to cooperating with the DMA, we have pointer to the DMA for the transmit and also for the receive. Here's only small summary of the API. Definitely we always have the init. Then for the communication periphery we have receive, we have transmit, and we using the shortcut underscore IT with the working with the interrupt and underscore DMA with working with the DMA. And there is something specific like for the ADC to configure the channel or in the RTC to set the alarm. And we always can get the state from our periphery or the set the state. About the interrupts, I will talk little bit later. Because now the next lesson will be the interrupt. Then the standard one, be careful, we have one interrupt handler, you know it, we calling then the HL interrupt routine, like in the XT lab. And then we can have multiple callbacks, not only one, but multiple. Then this I will show you in the next lab.